fingers. Can I tell you what just happened? Man, what a great way to wake up, especially on a Monday. So I get up and I go into the space. Oh, the hummingbird is over at my sunflower, which is now drooping and has come full circle. And I didn't even know it could extrapolate something from a sunflower. Is there nectar that they give, especially in their last season of blooming? Okay, so this morning is really, really, really magical. I wake up in my space of gratitude. I wake up in my space of stretching and getting clear. And what does this evolving earth and what does my highest sense of divinity call for today? And I can't live any other way. I need to be really honest. I don't know how to get up and do what I want to do from a place that is solely independent and self-interested. I'm just not wired that way. And I'll be even more honest in saying that after losing my daughter last year, nothing matters except for the work. I mean, nothing. So this morning, being very clear, coming downstairs, making my healthy medicinal morning beverage, and I come outside and my plumeria is going another round of blooms, which it's never done before. Not this late in the season. It started in May in my house and it is still going. And I was speaking to it and thanking it. And I came and I sat out here on my deck, okay? And the minute I sat down, and I'm gonna attach a picture to this video, a dragonfly came and immediately perched right here on my forehead, right on my third eye, right on my sixth chakra, and basically conveyed to me where my focus needed to be. Developing clarity here, seeing out with the world's eyes, with eyes to see and ears to hear, is the message. Developing this inner intuition, developing pineal gland, expanding on what's beyond that veil, the 95% of what we don't see, to be a more deliberate, a more focused earth anchor. And when I say earth anchor, I always mean a new earth anchor. We're transitioning out of this density. We all are. The planet's doing it. Pay attention, go look it up. It's happening. Any of you that follow my work, we've talked about it plenty of times. We have to do our own research. We have to advocate for ourselves. We have to educate ourselves. And when we do that, when we start to crack open even the slightest degree of personal interest, there will be a trickle in that will eventually become a landslide that will ultimately reveal and usurp most of what you thought you knew and replace it with a whole new level of unfiltered, unbiased, unprejudiced awareness about your divinity, your role here, what's going on, why you're here for the big show. So I'm going to attach the pictures of the dragonfly. You may notice a lot of my videos are like zero vanity, you know, like jammies and no makeup on and sometimes sweaty in the garden. I hope keeping it real makes it more interesting for the rest of you. Some people are always prepped and gorgeous for all their videos, and heaven bless them. They probably have a lot more subscribers than me. You have to look at me, but I am keeping it down to earth because you don't need to be spectacularly young, beautiful, and rich to do videos and inspire people. All you have to do is pass on the message that's inspiring you. So that's what I'm here for. Thanks for letting me share. Make this a magnificent day. Make it a powerful and transformative week. And never forget that the sentience all around us is always talking to us. Most of the time, we just keep walking by with filters over our ears and lenses over our eyes. Cheers, everybody. Happy earth anchoring. Be the solution.